Thanks for clicking on the extended version of my cast interviews for the very powerful film Only the Brave. Harkins Theaters, of course, based here in Arizona. This is an Arizona story, but it's really a story that affects everyone. And it's not only a love letter to the 19 Granite Mountain hotshots whose lives were lost on June 30th, 2013, but it's also a big thank you to all of our wildland firefighters and our first responders everywhere. Now is the time we need you all the most. Had a chance to sit down with the cast of this very well done film.
I want y'all to breathe in this beautiful vista, because you're never going to be able to look out into the wilds and see that pure beauty again.
It's just a community that I felt good being responsible, being the person that they felt would convey them in a way that was respectful.
I heard you guys had some slots available.
You lost?
We got one slot open.
You know what we're training for?
Hot shots get to engage the fire directly.
The SEAL Team 6 of firefighters.
If you give me a chance, I won't let you down.
When you see some of yourself in somebody else, as Eric did with Brendan in particular, you act different. You give him a chance.
Yeah.
You get it.
Yeah.
What about you did you see in Eric?
Oh, a lot. I mean, a lot, especially when I talk to his parents. I talk to Amanda, who I'm very, very close with now, and she's like a little sister to me now. There was a lot. I mean, we're both sober. We're both, you know, we were in situations, at least me in the firefighting community and what he was going for and what he wanted to do. And, you know, she would tell me that was like, I'm trying to piece a puzzle together to try to be able to play this thing, you know, accurately, but she's... The more time that we spent together, she said, you just did something that was very him, or you again. And then you start to see those parallels, and then you try to exploit those parallels when you're doing a scene or a movie.
What about you did you see in Brendan?
Well, my second grade teacher did tell my mother that I would never graduate high school and I was gonna be a juvenile delinquent, you know? So I think I had a lot of that. I got my fair share of, you know, mischief and trouble and stuff. It didn't mean I wasn't a good kid. I just, I needed somebody to kind of say, look, man, you don't want to do this for the rest of your life.
Donut! I think this is yours!
When we first met, it was just a really organic conversation. It really, just talking about family life, really, and just, you know, what is he into? What am I into? And I think, you know, Miles did a really good job of just being, you know, just so respectful and just making it feel as organic and authentic as possible, you know, and not just showing up and, hey, what was this like? He just really took the time to get depth into who I was and kind of what I was going through and how my brothers impacted my life.
Take this little stinker.
He's not a stinker.
Bye.
You have played a hero before who is no longer with us, and I read somewhere that you said it's like walking in someone's footsteps. So what was it like walking in Jesse's footsteps?
Jesse Steed has some big footsteps. That was, Jesse Steed was 6'4". Mm-hmm. I'm not. Jesse Steed was 220 pounds. I'm not. He was a former Marine. He's a lot of things I'm not. He had a great sense of humor. You know, he was this kind of larger than life guy who had the strength and the fortitude. This big guy would walk up to people and give them a big bear hug and say, I love you. Mm-hmm. I love you, man. And he would work 16 hours a day and then go home, and his wife would talk about how it was as if he hadn't spent 16 hours cutting line. Mm-hmm. That he was that present and that giving to her and their two kids. And I never met Jesse Steed, but he's taught me something. I've learned something from him. And all I can say is that I hope that that I've told his story, that we've told these guys' story and the story of their families with honor and integrity and a little bit of humility.
I cut a line along the base of that hill right there.
I've seen it a few times now, and it's just such a powerful film, and it's just so honoring to be able to see my brother's story told in such a magnificent way and such a huge platform. You know, these actors, Miles, really just breathed life back into who they were and what they did.
Do people still call you Donut?
Yeah.
I like the nickname.
It sticks.
And I like donuts.
Yep, who
so
doesn't?
Who doesn't?
Who doesn't like donuts?
Let's go, Bravo! Kick it up, max level!
Go, go, go!
Our first responders don't get the kind of treatment they deserve, especially not in Hollywood, and to be able to put this profession on screen and hopefully inspire kids to maybe not want to grow up and be Spider-Man, but grow up and be a hotshot, like, that's pretty cool.
I've had an amazing experience being getting to know his wife and his children a little bit, you know. His wife asked for some space in the beginning, mm-hmm. and she would talk to me on the phone. And here's this woman who was talking to me on the phone about Jesse at the same time as she's dressing their daughter. And her ability to talk to me and then be so kind and gentle with her daughter at the same time, I was struck by that. I was struck by that strength that she had. And what she talked about was Jesse's strength to go to work and then come back and be so present with them. And then she came on the second to last day of filming. She surprised me on set. Mm-hmm. And I got to meet her for the first time. And then this summer, we were playing in the, there's a charity softball tournament up in Prescott. Mm-hmm. And I met their children for the first time. And I got to, you know, give Caden and Cambria a high five and see Jesse and them. You know, this has been a humbling experience for me. And I hope we've done this the right way, but I also want people to know that Jesse and his family have touched me in a deep way and have changed me.
It's important that this Granite Mountain family pulls together and looks out for each other. Because we can't do this without your support.
When a movie means this much to you,
yep.
and again, we talked a year ago on the set,
yep.
do you have any say in the finished product when you put all of you into it and then now you're watching the first cut?
Yeah.
Are you able to control kind of some changes if there
no,
are
no,
any?
No, control is the right word, but I definitely have a say. I'm not very quiet, you know, as just a person. And I think there were a few things. I think the thing that was most important to me, not necessarily about the cut of the movie, but I had a lot of notes, a few notes, was the fact that when I saw it, even the third time I got so choked up afterwards, that it was important for me that the family see it alone and not together, that they could have their own experience without really worrying about the next family sitting right next to them and their experience, that it was kind of an isolated, personal experience for them, so that happened, and I was very happy that happened, and they seemed to all support the movie. You know, I think they were pleased with the spirit that the movie lives in.
No one could be prouder of his boys than I am of you guys.
I hope you enjoyed my cast interviews for the very powerful film Only the Brave. In fact, if you want to find out more about their philanthropic arm, it's Granite Mountain Fund, and you can go to their website. Also, don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, and giveaways, and we'll see you at the movies.